Hello and welcome to our service on Sunday the 17th of January, the second Sunday in Epiphany. Whilst our churches remain closed, our online service will be on Facebook on Sundays at 10 o'clock and also on YouTube. Thank you to everyone who contributes to our service, and hopefully we'll be able to meet again before too long to worship together. I hope you enjoy today's service.
Song's called 10,000 Reasons. Obviously, it's a huge poetic understatement when it comes to Jesus. His glory, His grace, His majesty, His mercy are there for us to see every day of our lives. Amen. Thank you. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship His holy name. And sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawn. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before, let me be seen where the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship His holy.
Your holy name, Jesus, I will. The reading today is taken from the first book of Samuel, chapter 3. The boy Samuel ministered before the Lord under Eli. In those days, the word of the Lord was rare. There were not many visions. One night, Eli, whose eyes were becoming so weak that he could barely see, was lying down in his usual place. The lamp of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. Then the Lord called Samuel. Samuel answered, "Here I am." And he ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." But Eli said, "I didn't call you. Go back and lie down." So he went and lay down. Again the Lord called, "Samuel." And Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "My son," Eli said, "I didn't call you. Go back and lie down." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord. The word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel a third time. And Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." Then Eli realized that the Lord was calling the boy. So Eli told Samuel, "Go and lie down. And if he calls you, say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. The Lord came and stood there, calling as at the other times, "Samuel, Samuel." Then Samuel said, "Speak, your servant is listening. This is the word of the Lord."
Yeah. Do you know what you're called to do? Better yet, do you know what you're called to be? In the World War II drama Fury, it focuses on one team of soldiers who fought from inside a tank against the Nazis in Europe. None of the men in the tank are quite as religious as Leboff's character Bible, but they all seem to understand what he believes in. He thinks, win or lose, live or die, that God put him in a position to do something about the evil of the Nazis by fighting against them. Bible knows he's supposed to be where he is because he's convinced God would want him to stop the evil Hitler was doing. Bible has a clear sense of calling. The scriptures are full of people who either denied their call or who recognized a change in their call and responded to the urging of God. My profession has a strong pattern of people who put off their call until latter life. So, what if we could learn from the Bible what we're supposed to be and how we could look for those patterns in our own lives? Now, Samuel is one of God's miracle babies. He's specifically prayed for by his mother Hannah, who mourns because she's infertile. When she discovers that she's pregnant, she calls her unborn baby Samuel, because I asked God for him. When he's old enough, she gives him to the priest Eli to raise in the temple as one of God's priests. The first sign of calling is recognizing that we are God's to begin with, and our lives find their purpose when we acknowledge God. Do you recognize that everything you have and everything you are capable of becoming is because God knit you together before you were born? So Samuel is raised up by Eli in the temple. He teaches him that the scriptures and what it means to be a priest. As he grew older, he gave more responsibility. Are you learning or are you going through the motions? Do you recognize a need to know more about God, the Bible, and prayer, your gifts, service, and witness? The second sign is recognizing the need to grow. Now Eli is raising Samuel as a son and a priest in the temple. Even when Eli's sons are falling away from what God called them to do, Samuel is growing in favor with God and all the people. People are noticing that he's good at being a priest, even while people are stirring against the sons of Eli. They were abusing power and taking what they wanted in terms of offerings. God's people needed priests, but the priests weren't getting it done. Someone had to rise up and be the voice of the people to God, and the voice of God to the people. The third sign of calling is recognizing the need for what you bring. What gifts and graces God has given you in your personality, skill set, and experience. The third sign is self-examination of your gifts and situation to see what you can bring. I'm going to Cornwall, having done so much self-examination as to how I can be best used post-coronavirus and being challenged by God that I couldn't retire and if anything, I needed to step up. Our boy priest is listening. Samuel hears God three times and he thinks Eli is calling out to him in the middle of the night to do something. Stoke the fire, check the locks. But Samuel is alert, even in the midst of sleep, to know that he is being called. The fourth sign is listening to the heartbeat of God running through our lives. How do we listen? We can read our Bible and reflect. God guides through it. Through what is preached, and we read in the written word, we can hear God's voice in prayer. Through the godly counsel of those with wisdom, through the spiritual gifts and just that inner hunch within. Back to our middle of the night story. Samuel thinks Eli is calling, But Eli knows it's really God, and it's Eli who points Samuel in the right direction. He tells Samuel to go back and to wait and to respond. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. Samuel was listening, but he didn't know how to differentiate between the noise. He couldn't identify the Lord's voice correctly until he was told, until the more experienced priest showed him how to respond correctly. He needed mentorship. The fifth sign of calling is confirmation and mentoring. It requires the community to be involved with the individual's call. I'm so grateful to the group of people who prayed for us when I was considering giving up my teaching job to train for the ministry, and then another godly crew who prayed when we needed to leave Exmouth to take up our call to Millfield, and now those who have been involved in the discernment process to go to Cornwall. Samuel goes on to have a pretty good career as God's priest. He anoints the first two kings of Israel. He speaks for God and develops the priesthood further. Samuel's heart and experience mixed with the call of God on his life connect in what Samuel does as he goes on to be the man of God who he was called to be. This was confirmed as well through others. The sixth sign of calling is responding in doing what you're called to do. So where are you? What signs are you seeing? Are you the one God is calling to help reset up the church post-coronavirus? Are you the one God is calling to lead the next mission project or fundraiser? Are you the one God is calling to pray more, be in church more, giving more of your time and money to benefit the church? Our call does change over time. My work is coming to an end in school, but God has new things for me to do in parochial situations. I redeveloped a flair, desire to do it all again. Sometimes we're called to change attitudes as well. I love the song, Here I Am, ending, Whom Shall I Send? Maybe it's you.
We are called by God. Jesus told us what we're called to do. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, and with all your strength. Love your neighbour as yourself. Love one another as I have loved you. Lord, help us to obey. Jesus said, if one of you wants to be great, he must be the servant of the rest. Lord, we hear your call. Help us to follow. Jesus said, unless you change and become humble like little children, you can never enter the kingdom of heaven. Lord, we hear your call. Help us to follow. Jesus said, go to all peoples everywhere and make them my disciples, and I will be with you always to the end of the world. In these difficult days, we may find ourselves in different ways called to serve. We may be like Eli, confined physically, but able to pray and share the knowledge of God. We may be like Samuel, young, active, able to do practical things. We may have a task unique to ourselves, befriending and listening or helping with advice. Help us, Lord, to discern what we can do for others. Heavenly Father, we bring to you all those suffering from the virus, especially those who are fighting for life. We pray for the families and friends of the patients, especially those who are feeling guilt or anger about loved ones who have died. We pray for all the workers in our NHS who are experiencing a workload like never before and an experience of grief which shakes them to their soul. Lord, we pray for a shared responsibility in our communities to protect the vulnerable and to curtail actions which may help the virus spread. We pray for the people who are isolated, both by the restrictions and winter weather. We think of those we know who have medical and mobility problems and do not have the ability to get out and exercise. We bring to you those who are depressed and trying to control mental turmoil. Heavenly Father, bring your comfort and peace to their situations. Help them to seek help. Enable others to realize that help is needed. We are fortunate in where we live that we have access to local places to walk for exercise. Help us to take time to appreciate the beauty, still apparent even on a winter's day. We give thanks that things can change, just like new green shoots appearing with a promise of future growth. So we look to the vaccines to help people interact again. We pray for all those who administer them and all who are organising distribution. The Lord who called us is the Lord who sends us. The Lord who gave us faith is the Lord who sends us to declare it. The Lord who loved us loves us still. The Lord who loves us still calls us and sends us to love one another. Amen. Let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still and striving cease. My comforter, my all and all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. then bursting forth in glorious day. Up from the grave he rose again, and as he stands at victory, sin's curse has lost its grip on me. For I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. And no power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand. And no power of hell, no scheme of man, can ever pluck me from his hand. Till he returns or calls me home, here in the power of Christ I'll stand.
Well, I hope you've all enjoyed today's service. As usual, a huge thank you to Becky and everyone who's taken part and put things together again this week. Let's just finish with a prayer. Lord, we thank you that we're all called to do something in your kingdom. Open our eyes to see our calling before you. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and forevermore. Amen.